Hi, today I'm going to do a deck study of the Dark Mirror Oracle cards. So this is what the deck looks like, and I really like it. I'm usually not that into cards that are more of a darker aesthetic, but for some reason I have found these to be very aesthetically pleasing. And when I first got them, I really wanted to use these for shadow work. So far, I haven't really done that yet. I've mostly used them for like deeper lessons when I did my predictions for 2022 pick card reading, which you can find in the eye in the right corner, right top corner, I think. But then when I got the deck, I was like, okay, some of these images and keywords make it very clear what the meaning is. Like this one here, we have obsession and we see this, I don't know if it is a plant or something strange happening around the head, the top part of the head, like there is something taking over the mind. But then there are also some cards that I'm like, okay, this is not something that instantly springs my intuition. And I also found the guidebook a little bit cryptic. Like, I don't know what it is in the spiritual community or in the spiritual, I don't know if it's the business side or whatever it is, but sometimes I feel like creators of a deck, whether that is tarot or oracle, they try to be so deep with how they try to word things and to be almost too figuratively that it doesn't make sense to me. First of all, English is not my first language. I don't know if that is also a barrier for this. I found that with my Muse tarot in the guidebook too, that sometimes I feel like the descriptions made by the creator of the deck are so cryptic and so too overly poetic that I don't understand what the card means. So in this guidebook, for every card, you get a moon phase, a stage of grief. You have some sort of like a sentence or some sort of description, but it doesn't always make sense. Force channeled outside, unreasonable, undirected but powerful. I'm sorry, what? How can I apply that to my life? How can I apply that to a reading? And then there is a visual seed, so a description of what you see on the card. And then it also has a sentence. So for this card, it's I've got to break free, I want to be free. And then it's a part of going dark. And that is the more poetic side of it that I don't always really get. So what I want to do for this deck study is I'm gonna flip you over to the table. I have sat with all of the cards from this deck one by one, and I've written down my own interpretations based on everything that I see in the card, plus everything that I read in the guidebook, and anything that came up intuitively while looking at the cards, looking at the guidebook. So let's do that. I'm gonna go through this deck card by card and share with you my interpretation of the card based on the image and the guidebook, and hopefully it will inspire you if you have this deck as well. So let's take a look. So for the first card, we have Triumph of Lies. So for this card, and with this key phrase of Triumph of Lies, to me, I think this is more about lying to keep up appearances, to keep up your reputation, because you care too much about judgment from others. There's a lack of self-confidence and not being authentic. And that is something that I got from the guidebook. If you have this deck and you would like to go through the interpretations with me, definitely grab an oracle journal of your own or your notepad on your computer or anything like that to write down any of my interpretations that you vibe with and that resonate with you. Then we have Temple of My Body. And to me, this is about feeling guilty about desires, having shame about ourselves, and an encouragement to feel proud of yourself and your body instead. Obsession. This is very much being focused on one thing and almost losing yourself in one idea. Is this me? The question is, how did I get there? You got lost on your journey, and do we like who we are right now? And it is an encouragement to start a new dream. Gilded regret, wanting to live in the past, thinking about missed opportunities. Alone in the world, there is power in solitude and there is a need for pause. Sacrifice, accept loss to move on. Things have to go for it to get better. The child I was meant to be. Hope heals the wounds of the past, and we need to get more connections to ourselves. Envious gluttony, it is an encouragement to recognize your own own jealousy. Colorless angel. You are ignoring your pain. You are trying to be cold instead of facing your pain, which is what you are encouraged to do. Addicted. Going back to something that is bad for you. Artificial heart. Being on autopilot instead of feeling, and nothing can guarantee happiness, but you still have to allow yourself to feel any pain. Blinded to pain. Carrying a lot of pain, but pretending it's not there, and it is an encouragement to remember that you are human and that you are allowed to feel. Hiding your true self. There is a lack of trust, and you are encouraged to be your authentic self. Masquerade. Keeping up a mask and pretending to not care. Black flower fragrance. The world is unfair and tell people to fuck off because you have a right to exist, even though you are not perfect. Forgetting oneself. It is taking a lot out of you, and you should allow yourself to be selfish every once in a while. Naked before the stars. Accept your own beauty. When we shine, our world becomes brighter. Parasite. Misery loves company. People are trying to bring you down with their own negativity. Downcast pride. You are bending yourself to please others. You are having no dignity. Bride in a cage. You keep thinking that tomorrow will be better. There's a thing of procrastination happening here. I won't cry for you. It's a card of getting closure, moving on, breaking up, and letting go of hopes, dreams, memories, and feelings. Revenge, getting back, standing up for yourself because you've been hurt. Queen of my world. This is a card of setting boundaries and being in your power. It's a card of confidence. Fated to suffer. Do you believe in fate? You have a choice for your life, even though you're feeling forced by the universe. Peaceful among thorns. The spiritual cannot solve the material, but it can help you. It's also a card of enlightenment. Fragmentation. You are experiencing multiple emotions, anger and confusing, and they are breaking you. It is a need to mend yourself. Perchance to dream, I don't know that word, but I've written down that it is time to surrender. It is a moment of weakness, wanting to disappear, wanting to sleep and hope that everything will be solved when we wake up. Anger and chains. You are feeling unreasonable but powerful. And it's an encouragement to break free. Calling the storm. Don't fear the storm, but embrace it. And after it has gone, we can start over. Atonement. It's a card of accepting the burden of responsibility. Not all things burn, but some should. Today for tomorrow. Hope is in the present, and you are encouraged to start building the future. Now that I've written everything down in my Oracle journal, I feel so much more confident in using this deck for readings, not only for myself, but for possibly for clients, as well as for this YouTube channel. So that was my deck study of the Dark Mirror Oracle cards. I would love to hear in the comments down below what your thoughts are. How did you like this deck study? Would you like to see more of these deck study videos? I also want to do one for the Muse Tarot, but I also would like to know, do you like it when I have done the interpretations beforehand and I'm sharing them with you? So you, if you have this deck, you can sort of copy mine, or you can be inspired by mine. Or do you want me to go through the entire deck and write it all down on camera? So definitely let me know that in the comments down below. If you want to book a personal tarot reading with me, you can do so through either my coffee shop or my Etsy shop. Both links are in the description box below. And if you want to see more videos on tarot, definitely subscribe to this channel because I do those all the time. But for now, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time.